Hey guys, it's Goofy Goop the Balls, and today I have for you guys a 26 gun streak in Advanced Warfare. This is the closest I've been able to get to a DNA bomb so far. I keep working for it, but I'm not able to get it seems, but I'm sure I'll get it eventually. So like always guys, I'll give you guys the class I'm using and the kill streaks, and talk to you a little bit about getting a DNA bomb and things like that. And one thing to keep in mind is that this gameplay is a little bit older. I can't even remember how long ago I got this, so some of the things about my class or my setup might be a little older or outdated than what I used to use, or what I use now, sorry. But anyways, let's get into it. So as for the gun I'm using the AK-12, pretty standard for my nuke classes. This seems to be like the best gun for me to get nukes. And then the attachments are the suppressor, the grip, and the quick draw attachment. And like I said, this gameplay is a little bit older, so this is before I stopped using the quick draw attachment. Now, as for perks, I'm using low profile. I'm pretty sure I'm using either cold-blooded or blind eye. And for the third slot, I'm pretty sure I'm using toughness and scavenger in this gameplay. And then I'm also using the exo overclock ability, which is the one that makes you move faster for like 10 or 20 seconds. And again, like I said, guys, this gameplay is a little bit older, so this is before I stopped using that. And for the kill streaks, I'm running the UAV threat detection and the system hack with the extra points. And now this again is before when the system hack was only 600 points and the extra points attachment only made it 650. But now it's 700 points and the system hack assist points is 750. So I usually don't run it, but I did in this gameplay. So I think the most important thing for this class is running the UAV threat detection. And to get a DNA bomb, you're going to have to kill 30 people in one life, and that's a ton. So you're going to need all the help you can get. And the UAV with threat detection really makes it easy to get kills on people who don't run low profile. And to get a DNA bomb, chances are you're going to have to run it, and there's going to be the enemy team, they're going to have most of the people not using low profile, because it just makes it easier for you to see them, and you won't get killed from behind as often. Now, I'm not saying that you absolutely have to play noobs, I'm just saying that that helps. So anyone not running low profile is really going to help you get your DNA bomb. And as for my gun, you always do want to use a suppressor because that, again, helps you stay off the radar just like low profile. And the most time you spend off the radar is better for you because less people will come and try to get revenge kills and try to hunt you down and kill you. So that'll help you stay alive longer so you can get those 30 kills in one life. Now, as for the game mode you want to play something that's going to give you a lot of points for kills. So I'm playing Domination here, and Domination now gives you 100 points per kill, and then 200 for a flag cap and other things like that, but the most important thing is the 100 points per kill. So that way you only need exactly 7 kills to get to that UAV with threat detection, and that's all you need. You just need the 7 more kills to keep looping that around, cycling that streak, and keep getting more UAVs so you can keep your streak going a little bit easier. And like I talked about in one of my other videos, once you get those first 7 kills and you get the assist points off the UAV, you probably only need about 5 kills or so to keep getting more UAVs and keep your streak alive. In contrast, however, if you played a game mode where you only get 50 points a kill, like Momentum say, then you'd need 14 kills to get that UAV, and then even with the assist points, you probably need like 10 or 11 more, and that's just way too long. I mean, you'll only end up getting 2 or 3 UAVs before you get your DNA bomb, and that's not what you want, because that leaves it way too much up to chance and not on your own terms. Because you really want to make the most use of your kill streaks to help you get to this DNA bomb, because in this game, with skill-based matchmaking and all, it's pretty hard to do that. And now, the last thing I want to talk about is gunfights, and this is going to sound a little vague, but you don't want to put yourself in any gunfights that you know you're going to lose. So let's say you pop around a corner and you see an enemy, and he's already looking at you because for whatever reason he knew you were around that corner. So instead of trying to pull up your gun real quick and trying to win that gunfight, it's better for you to sort of exo boost back behind that wall so that you're safe, because the most important thing here should be about staying alive. Your first priority should be staying alive, because this is a long streak. You don't want to play aggressive, you want to play it safe. So when your first primary goal is to stay alive, helps you stay alive longer and get that streak over time, because it's better to get that streak over a long period of time than to rush and have a chance of not getting it at all. And just to continue on that point, you always want to be near some sort of cover so that if any time during a gunfight you think you're not going to be able to win it, it's easier for you to just jump around that so you're around and behind that cover, and that'll help keep you alive. So always remember to keep some sort of cover, some kind of wall near you when you're going to engage in a gunfight or you think you're going to engage in a gunfight, because you need to stay alive. So yeah guys, I just want to talk to you a little bit about this class and a couple tips to help you guys go on those bigger streaks and maybe get those DNA bombs. And when I do get my DNA bomb, I'll make another video showing you guys that and talking more about the best practices to help you get a DNA bomb. So if you guys enjoyed this video, I'd really appreciate it if you could hit that like button. And if you guys are new to my channel, feel free to hit that subscribe button. That way you can stay up to date every time I post a new video or gameplay. This has been Goofy Goop2Balls, and I'll catch you all in the next video.